the 1970s when John Lee came to California. I don't know the exact specifics of it, but he ended up hooking up with Canned Heat, were big fans of his.
When we met John Lee Hooker, we were at the airport in Portland, Oregon, arriving to do a gig. And all of a sudden, we're picking up our luggage, and John Lee Hooker is two stands away, picking up his old guitar. So we see him, and, hey, there is John Lee Hooker. I'd like to meet John Lee Hooker. So we all run, you know. We were the groupies, you know. And John, we are always admire you. We always love you. And he turns and says, well, who are you, you know? And I said, well, we are the Canned Heat. The Canned Heat, you know, I like your music. If you recall, in the 50s, for example, there was segregation in the radio and TV, much more. So by us, the white musicians taking the blues and carrying the banner and making it famous, we made it acceptable and we made it art form that is now recognized worldwide, just like jazz. A true American art form that it is worldwide.
It was the white audience that came in and started listening to the blues with the Paul Butterfield, the Michael Bloomfield, and naturally Rolling Stones and people like that kept saying the music they were playing was copied from the John Lee Hookers, the Muddy Waters, and the black people here in America who wasn't well known as they are today.
The last of a generation of the root, you know. There's a lot of branches lately and a lot of, you know, but he's the main root, you know. He's a direct connection with the root of blues, which is the best contribution America has given to the world, the roots, blues and jazz. That's our contribution to the world.
Bridge that Delta blues origin and the nature of his music with Carlos Santana's music and still make great music that doesn't have any awkwardness to it whatsoever is he's completely unique in that. The blues purists, it's always driven me crazy where they have opinions about who is and who isn't blues and whether or not somebody can play blues or not because of the color of their skin. This is a sort of discussion that really drives John Lee crazy. But unfortunately, there's a lot of people that feel that it has to be from a certain time, it has to be done in a certain way, it has to be a certain color of skin, or it's not real blues.
When someone asked him one time about having a mixed band, white and black musicians, he said, when you listen to music and you close your eyes, do you see colors? I don't.
You remember John Lee?
No, I've never seen
him. I've never seen him. I've never seen this guy before.
How you doing, John? Well, I have to tell you a thing about that.
Yeah, I first met him when he came. He was part of the folk blues festivals that John Lee Hooker was a pioneer in that, and he was the first American blues artist who was brought over to do strictly a club tour of England, and it was such a monstrous success that other artists followed. There's a certain mystique about him, and that, of course, that mystique is really one of his main things today that you notice. He has a certain quality about him that no other blues artist has as a person. He was, of course, very thrilled to find that all these English white people in pubs across the country were all into the blues and knew his music probably better than people on his own from his own country.
In London, when I was older, in the 60s, you know, I think they were around. And John was on tour with me. Eric Clapton was with him. That's how I got to know John. He was a young man.
The concept that's often overlooked is the idea of less is more. And John Lee has this ability to play in one key for 10 minutes and make it exciting and interesting. And he has his own very unique style of guitar playing.
Go away, go away. Leave me alone. Night, 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 night. Night, 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 night. Please go away. Stop riding me like a pony. Night, night. I ain't your pony. Night, night, go away. Ooh, ooh, ooh. Ooh.
Often bass players or guitar players, they discover their technique and they just play a million miles, you know, a second. But which is okay. But I think, you know, you got to sort of breathe too. Let the music breathe. You know, and then when you do play fast and complicated, it means something. You know, and I think John Lee is one of the great teachers of that concept. The idea of being able to just let the music breathe, and it's how you play that one note for 10 minutes. You know.
It's Cindy.
A king band. That
yeah, you go swing.
Yeah. They were terribly.
In England, younger blues aficionados such as John Mayall and Alexis Korner and Mick Jagger and Keith Richards and various others, David Bowie even, who called his first band the Crawlin' Kingsnakes, I understand, which is the title of one of John Lee's songs, they'd all built an enthusiasm for American blues.
Well, it's for me, it suited the rebelliousness of my nature. I couldn't find it. It was the most extreme form of music, I suppose, that I'd ever heard. And then when I found out about the kind of lifestyle that was involved, it was even more attractive because there was a sort of gangsterish background to it at all as well, with the clubs and drink and women, and just the whole thing was incredibly appealing to me.
He was smart enough and lucky enough to not have to be abusing his body with drinking too much and smoking too much. He gave that up a long time ago, so I think on top of being all the things I said, he's also very wise.
That was a time when Janis Joplin and Jimi Hendrix, when they overdosed. And both of them were very good friends of his. And at that particular time, you know, after they died, and then to see his son go through the same thing, of course, you know, there's a premonition there of death, you know what I mean? You know, you begin to feel that death is imminent because, wow, my friends just happened. It hit kind of close to home, and, you know, and, yeah, it was real tough for my mom and my dad. And I know a lot of times when he made some of his songs, he used to tell me, I can really sing the blues because I got the blues right here in this house. And I used to watch him sing the blues, and I used to hear him moan, and I used to, you know, just watch him moan at home.
Nobody know. Nobody know what I've been through. Nobody know. Know what I've been through. Sometimes I didn't have food go on my table, and that's why I sang the blues. You got to feel it,
yeah.
You got to know it.
Daddy wants you to go to sleep, see?
You got to be done, yeah. Through these things, I sang the blues. That's why nobody knows I've been through.
I think the most difficult time my father had to face was the divorce that he went through. I think that was just the most traumatic thing and the hardest thing that he had to deal with, because he really loved my mom.
I mean, what could be any tougher than that? You know, he had all of us, but he didn't have his marriage. And when you have to separate the mama from the siblings, and we all can't be together, you understand? That takes something out of you, you know, and I believe if he had a chance to do it all over again, I guess we all would no doubt do it different than we had done it before, you know?
At first, I couldn't stand him. We could, he would call to the house to talk. I wouldn't talk to him. I would give the phone to my older daughter. You talk to your daddy. I don't want to talk to him. So finally, I don't know what happened. You know, we got to be very good friends, you know. We communicate together. I guess we got that bind together. We'll always have that, you know.
I have a lot of love for her as a friend, not as a lover, as a friend. I have a lot of love for her. Well, she had my children. And I would break up, you know, there's something between me and her, which I don't talk about, but we got to be good friends, and I always look out for her.
Life isn't always, you know, a laugh, you know, it's it can be serious, and there's hard times and there's good times, and
being a deep thinker like John is, I think anybody like that would have a certain kind of aloneness inside, you know. It's, and blues is like a salve for that, you know. When I didn't have a place to go and I didn't have any money and I was down on my luck and broke and I'd go by to see John Lee. I wouldn't tell him that I had no place to go and that I was broke, but he just knew. And he'd say, "Oh, well, why don't you stay here and go in the kitchen, fix yourself something to eat." And that's real typical of John, his big heart that he has.
I got just about everything I want in life. Love, success, money, cars, homes. I got all that. But one thing I never get enough of, love from people. I never get enough of people loving me and I loving people. You can't get too much of that.
I don't think he looks back. I don't think he has any regrets about how he did it. I think he, he'll always say if he had to go today, he would not have any regrets as he looked back. And I think each and every one of us would like to live our lives like that, to be able to say when it's my time, I can say I don't have any regrets, that I've done all the things that I want to do.
I won't be here always. I don't think I will. My music will be here forever and forever and forever. When I'm gone, my music will be here, ringing in the people's ears, in their homes, in their cars that we play. That's John Lee Hooker's voice. It's still me, but it's not me in flesh and blood. My memories will forever be here for generation and generation to come. It will carry on my music. When I first started traveling, I left home when I was young. When I first started traveling.
Hey, thank you for all the good times.
Oh yeah, I'll get my people on doing as long as they can.
Hey, appreciate it, man. Thanks.
Okay.
Yeah.
I hate this.
Keep on, keep going. Hey, we appreciate all that good music, man. Thanks a lot. You're the man. Hey, you have a good one too, bro.
Shoot you right down. Yeah. Right on for fun. Your feet. Take you home with me. I'm going to put you in my arms. I'm going to boom, 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 boom. I love to see you walk.
Wow.
Wow.
Okay.
He's not touring like he used to. In my time of working with John and over this couple decades, we'd change the touring to fit what worked for him. But he still likes to play, and I think playing is really important for him. He gets in front of an audience, he gets that feedback, and everybody, and maybe in many cases, artists more than everybody else, have insecurity and appreciate that feedback and that response from an audience, especially when you're older and you're not doing a regular job every day. He goes out there and he knows that he's still vital and he gets a tremendous response.
Hey,
As you walked and walked and talked and talked and whispered in the air.
People are gonna remember John Lee as probably the king of the boogie, you know, I think.
You're gonna do the boogie, you'll dance all over the place, I don't care.
It's getting up and shaking your tail. It's a groove. It's dancing. It's a dancing thing. It's feel-good music. And, you know, he does it. It's his trademark at the end of the shows. He gets people up, you know. It's a thing where, like, you know, it's shaking the bad, you know, out of your system. It's getting up. It's at the end of the show. You feel good now. It's like therapy.
A lot of people, you know, they say to me, how old is John Lee Hooker? I'm not even going to ask that question. Oh, but I tell you, there's many guys, you know, many years younger that can't do what John Lee does. So it don't matter.
Put it in, Fisher. Baby.
Jim Fisher. Bow! Bow! Which coach?
Audience that discovered him, and there were many people that were giving him, you know, the great acknowledgement that he deserved. But John Lee Hooker was always John Lee Hooker. You know, there was no change in John. You know, maybe he has a couple more cars, but you know, he can only drive in one Cadillac at a time. But he was, you know, John was never a guy that, you know, needed to flaunt anything or prove anything.
That's my story, that's my story, people. That's my story of my life.
Long time. You want me to come right over. This is a hit, pretty baby. This is a hit, pretty baby. This is a hit, pretty baby now. And bust around and fell in love. Kiss me true.